Sonny's Piano TV Show. Today, an Art Case Steinways and Other Beautiful Piano Special Edition, featuring an Art Case Steinway Splash. Spectacular photo montages. Another exclusive Sonny's Piano Yoga Tip. And introducing a brand new segment, Steinway News. And now, here's Sonny.
Hi, I'm Sonny. I want to welcome you to another Sonny's Piano TV Show. This is the TV show that's completely devoted to pianos, to music, to health and well-being, and to you. And as usual, lots of new things here today at Sonny's Piano TV Show. Today's show is called Art Case Steinways and Other Beautiful Pianos. And that's what we're going to do, is going to feature some of the beautiful, beautiful Art Case Steinways that we currently have in our inventory. And also we're going to show you some photos that go back 10 years of some of the most outrageously beautiful pianos that we've had here of a variety of different brands. And pianos, they are just gorgeous. Not only are they phenomenal instruments that make us feel good, but each one, each and every piano is a work of art in itself. And this is a perfect example of that. We just did a video tour of this piano, and this is a Art Case Steinway that was made in 2003 to celebrate their 150th anniversary. So they made this pretty much an exact replica of the pianos, Art Case pianos that we were making at the turn of the last century. So let's get right to it. This is a video splash of some of the Art Case Steinway pianos that we have here at Sonny's right now and that we've had in the past. So I hope you enjoy it. Today, we are just blessed and overjoyed to present to you this Steinway Model B, made in 1881. This is an Art Case piano. The legs are pre-Victorian. They're just absolutely gorgeous. The piano is just stunning to look at and stunning to play. This is a rosewood, new pin block, new strings, new hammers, new shanks, new whippings. They refinished it, even got a new soundboard. This is a magnificent Steinway Model A, made in 1904, King Louis XVI style piano. The original owner was an artist. And he purchased the piano, and then he created this case that he put over the original Steinway. This is a Steinway A 6-footer. This was rebuilt on the inside within the past decade or so.
20 years or so, 20.
So it's got new pins.
New pins, new pin block, new strings, sounding board's been reshimmed.
This music desk, this is I've never seen anything like this. This ornate was part of what they called the Crown Jewel series. This is an exotic mahogany. The player system is a piano disc player system, and this one takes both floppies and the round CD. We did a regulation on the action, which means we pull the action out and made multiple adjustments to each of the 88 notes. You can play light on this, or you could play very robust. The player system can be upgraded to use a flash drive or an iPad. The Steinway Model M, made in 2001, 5'7". And the wood here is bobinga, very exotic grain. It comes from Africa, and boy, this is some furniture piece, and it's some instrument. This also is a player piano. Steinway Model M 1928 Art Case piano. And it's a beautiful mahogany with a beautiful art case, and the legs on this, I've only seen one other like this. This was rebuilt maybe 10 years ago, and they put on new bass strings, new dampers, new pins, regilded the plate, varnished the board, put on new Steinway hammers and shanks, kept the original beautiful condition ivories. It was refinished about 2 or 3 years ago, and they did a remarkable job. A Steinway Model B, made in 1889. This is rosewood. This is an 85 keys, a lattice music desk, original ivory keys. It has new pins, new whippings, new shanks, new dampers,
They regilded the plate, they shimmed the soundboard, they refinished the beautiful rosewood. It appears to be a new pin block in here, and this has a player system in it.
Steinway Model M, 5'7" long, made in 1929, but just recently rebuilt. This is a King Louis style art case, and it has the King Louis the 15th style legs, the beautiful pedal lyre, the beautifully carved music desk, and the lid that has a special bevel, and it's a beautiful walnut, and it was just beautifully refinished. It has a new pin block, it has new strings, it has a new German Renner action. This is a Victorian style Steinway Model C. Flame mahogany, exotic mahogany, made in 1902, rebuilt about 25, 30 years ago. When they rebuilt it, they put on new pins, new strings, new dampers, they regilded the plate, they put on new Steinway hammers and shanks and flanges, and the piano is in just impeccable condition. The soundboard is great, the bridges are great, and it plays great. This is called the Centennial Edition, and it's a 5'7" Steinway Model M. They made the rounded legs with brass ferrules on the bottom and on the top. They have the rounded arms, very nice here too. And then also on the music desk, it's a little rounded here, very subtle. And then I think the most unique thing about it is that the pedals are all made out of brass, all brass, and very interesting ornament. The Steinway Model L that was made in 2003 to commemorate the 150th anniversary of Steinway. This is an exact replica of what they made around the turn of the previous century. It has the lattice music desk, hand-carved, very, very beautiful, hand-rubbed satin ebony. It has the beautiful legs that were made on a lot of the art case pianos for Steinway, and it has the whole design of the piano around the case and the arms, and everything is part of what they did during that century. Well, wasn't that something? Just beautiful, 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 beautiful pianos. R.K. Steinway pianos are phenomenal. But now we're going to roll into what I call a photo montage of many of the art case pianos that we've had here over the past 10 years. And these aren't just the Steinways. These are just all different brands, and they are just beautiful. So check these out. I think you'll be very, very impressed. Thank you. As I mentioned earlier, we are about to embark on our fourth Win a Free Piano contest on Facebook. And this time we're calling it Win a Free Steinway contest because we're giving away three Steinways. And you can learn more about that by going to my website at sonnyspianotv.com. But the contest that works this way, people go to our Facebook page, they upload a video of themselves playing the piano or the keyboards, and then they get their friends to vote for them and share the link to their video, and whoever gets the most amount of votes at the end wins one of the three Steinway pianos that were given away this year. So, these contests have been so much fun. People have been uploading videos of themselves from all over the country, and people have been voting from all over the world. And we have videos from little four-year-olds up to professionals. We're going to roll right now into a video splash of some of the videos that were uploaded into our previous contest. Hope you enjoy it. Weren't those kids great? It was just phenomenal to see all of them playing. And we've come up with this video splash idea to bring a lot of them to you all within a short period of time. And the contest has just begun on Facebook. So if you want to learn more about it, visit us at sonnyspianotv.com, and you could see more of these kind of videos. And now we're going to have what I call one of my piano yoga tips for playing the piano instantly. This is a series of tips that I've created that will show you how to get around on the piano, even if you've never touched the note. I've had a special request to show people how to play the Moonlight Sonata, and I'm just going to show you a very simplified version of just the first few passages in there. So here it is. Okay, everyone, here's my shortened version of Moonlight Sonata. It's a really quick and easy, sunny tip for today. Moonlight Sonata. First start with the left hand. Now, the way the piano works is the first note is A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and it's just a constant repeating pattern. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So, if you put your thumb on A, and then you play G, and then you play F, and then you play D, and then you play E. Yep, that's pretty much what you're going to be doing with left hand with some embellishment. So let's do that a few times together. So you play flat A, 3, 4, then you play this, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then you play the F twice, then you play the D twice, and then you play the E twice. Then you come back and play the A four times again, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that's the whole pattern. All right, you start off playing the A four times, then you play the G four times, then you play the F four twice, then you play the D twice, and then you play the E twice, and you come back and play the A four times again. So it ends, and then you begin playing the A four times again. All right, so I would just do it, you know, to start with, maybe do this 50 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then just get the feel of it. 2, 3, 4, and then play this 1, 2, 1, 2, one, two, and then play this four times again, two, three, four, and then start again, all right? So that's basically the left hand chord pattern. Of course, if you want to expand on that, you could play an octave. You could play the octave up here, an octave. It means eighth, so you're going to play an A and an A, all right? Or an A and an A. So you can just do it with a full octave, too. You can go two, three, four, and then one, two, three, four, and then one, two, and then D twice, and then E twice, and then you're back to the A. Another way of doing it is a triad or a simple chord. So this is really actually an A minor, two, three, four, and this is a G major. So actually all you're going to be doing is keeping this 1-3-5 position here on this. Go like that, and then just everybody moves down one. You're playing the 1-3-5 again. Everybody moves down one, there, there. And then when you come back up, instead of playing E minor, you just raise it up to a G sharp, and there you go. So that's basically the left hand. So now let's move to the right hand. All right, so what we're going to do with the right hand is, let's see, this is middle C, right? And it's A, B, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. So we're going to put the thumb on the E, all right? And then we're going to play the index finger, the A. And then we're going to play the fourth finger on the C. So we're going to go play that four times, and then we play it again four times. And with the left hand, you'll be going like this. We're going one, two, three, four. You're going to move down to the G. One, two, three, four. Then you're going to play twice with the F, except you're going to change just the thumb is going to play F-A-C instead of E-A-C. So you're going to go twice, and then the thumb is going to come down to the D when the left hand goes to the D, and you're going to go D-F-A twice, and then you're going to play E-G-sharp-B, and then twice, and then back to here and do that four times to end this one. Two, three, four, one, two, three, four, and then F-A-C, twice, D-F-A, twice. And you could do your own version of this. But that's basically the ballpark of the breaking down Moonlight Sonata to a very easy way of improvising and just playing and having some fun. And of course, the more you do it, the more you'll be able to just flow around. So you could be doing stuff like this, playing an octave with the left hand and with the right hand. You can be going, and you could just play any note. Once you have the left hand a chord pattern into your muscle memory, as my video technician and audio technician Vladimir just reminded me, muscle memory. If you get this into your muscle memory, then it just flows. So you could be going, any of the white notes will work. Especially if you just keep the left-hand chord pattern locked in there. Fun. Piano playing, healthy, fun, enjoyable, easy. The more you hang around and with the keys and just noodle around, the more that will come out. So that's our quick, easy version of Moonlight Sonata for you today.
And now, a stunning photo montage of Steinways and other beautiful pianos.
¶¶
Weren't those beautiful? I just got to tell you, I feel blessed to be able to bring and share these pianos with you. Now we're actually going to roll into something new here on Sonny's Piano TV Show. We are going to have a new segment, and we're going to call this Steinway News. So bring you different news stories that have been in the media about Steinway & Sons company over the past couple months. So here it is. Da-da-da-da, Steinway & Sons Company News. In August, Steinway was purchased by a hedge fund called the Paulson Company, and for $500 million. Steinway was a privately owned company up to that point, and actually it was a very interesting story what happened. One other hedge fund bid about $438 million for them, and it looked like they were going to purchase them. And then the Samick Company, the Korean piano company, who owned about 35% of their stock, they made a larger, higher bid. So it looked like they were going to own Steinway & Sons. But then the Paulson hedge fund came in, and they bid over $500 million, so they ended up purchasing it. Now, according to news sources and interviews with the CEO of the Paulson hedge fund, they are not going to change anything. They want to keep on keeping the quality of the great Steinway pianos, and what they're going to do is actually try to share the Steinway pianos with the rest of the world, because primarily they're here in America, because Steinway was here in Astoria, Queens, which is about an hour away from us here at Sonny's Pianos. And also they had a factory in Hamburg, Germany, on and off throughout the years, and it's still there now too. But so there's some Steinways in Europe and some Steinways, mainly most of the Steinways are here in America. Then Bank of America just recently loaned the Paulson Group $75 million to market the Steinways out worldwide. So, you know, if Steinways, you know, there's a lot of great pianos out there, the Bösendorfer, the Bechstein, Bluthner, but pound for pound, you know, I think the Steinway just consistently through the years, it just makes the best piano in the world. They came to this country from Germany in 1853, and through a civil war, two world wars, inflations and depressions, Steinway is still making incredible pianos. They made incredible pianos from the moment they landed here to this day. And if it says Steinway on it, it's a great piano. I know a lot of people go into, well, the pianos from this era were better than the pianos from that era, and I played them all, and they're all phenomenal instruments. So we're just happy to be able to be a pre-owned Steinway specialist, and we're, you know, have these pianos here for you to come down and enjoy. And also, Steinways are made here in America, and this is one of the things that America does better than anyone else in the world, and that's to make a great piano and, consistently, and just beautiful instruments. So it's kind of a patriotic act, I think, that the Paulson Company purchased Steinway and kept the ownership here in America. So thank you to the Paulson Group, and that's our Steinway news for this TV show. So that's it for today's show. I hope you enjoyed it. And also I want to announce the grand reopening of Sonny's Pianos. We have entered into a new warehouse and showroom that's just 5 minutes from the old one in Holbrook. This one is in Bohemia, and it's much bigger, and we have lots more pianos here. So if you want to come down and visit us, just give us a call and make an appointment, and we will turn you loose in here, and you can play one of the many, many pianos that we have here. We have about 50 pianos down here, about 40 of them are Steinways. So come on down and have a piano experience. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.